For as long as I've been making homemade PCBs, I've used tonal transfer method. From quite early on, I've used off-the-shelf laminator for applying the required pressure and heat. This way the results are decent, but the problem is that it can take close to 10 passes for the toner to fully transfer. Board and toner just won't heat up enough during one pass. Laminator can be modified to achieve decent results with just one pass. Some users replace the internal thermostat with higher value one. That gives desired results, but the internal temperature of the laminator also rises. In my opinion, slowing down the feed rate could be a better option. To slow down the rollers on my laminator, I designed a circuit and ordered the PCBs from the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. For as low as $5 plus shipping, you can get 10 pieces of 100x100mm high-quality PCBs made in just a couple of days. These boards shown now are designed by me, you got Rishak Vlog, and made by PCBWay.com. If you have a project that needs professionally made PCB, for all your PCB prototype needs, check out PCBWay.com. Back to the project. Soldering montage was supposed to be shown at this point, but the camera operator of this film crew forgot to press the record button. For that reason, it's time to do some magic. Done. The mains comes in from two of these pins, gets converted to 5 volts by this power supply module. That 5 volt powers the 8085, which controls the opto-isolator, which in turn triggers the triac that controls the motor connected to another two pads on the left side of the board. Both wires of the motor go through this board. I've included snapper circuit, which is supposed to reduce spikes caused by switching inductive loads. Spikes can kill the triac, causing it to malfunction. There's a socket for the AT-5. The microcontroller is supposed to be programmed externally. I don't see myself updating the firmware all that often, so this is a suitable option. To have an option of adding some kind of inputs and outputs, I have broken out two GPIO pins and power pins to this 4-pin pin header. One very important safety aspect is that the power supply must have a proper isolation if the circuit has any parts that the user is able to touch. That is why I'm using isolated power supply and an opto-isolator. To describe this circuit with few words, I'd describe it as a solid-state relay with built-in slow-frequency PWM timer. Because the power supply is in module format, it can be easily replaced with a cheaper, non-isolated capacitive dropper. That is the main reason I didn't include the ISP connector for the AT-Tiny. Connecting anything to the mains referenced device can be dangerous. Component selection isn't the only thing to consider when making mains connected devices. If we take a look at the other side of this PCB I have here, there's a distinctive areas for the mains electricity side and the low voltage side. Between the opto-isolator pins, which is the shortest distance between those two sides, I have added an isolation cutout. Please, before designing mains powered circuits, study proper clearance distances and other safety aspects. The code for this device is simple as it could get. Set one pin output and toggle it high and low at set intervals. In this case, on for half a second and off for 9.5 seconds. The actual timing depends on toner, laminator temperature and other variables. It's time for a demonstration. I have the same board and print as before. This time, perfect toner transfer will happen during one pass. Every 10 seconds the board moves about 1.5mm or 1/16th of an inch. So this single pass will take much longer than before, but that is passive time. I don't need to interact with the laminator during this time. And look at that. Perfect transfer. There are still other things that will affect the result of making PCB with toner transfer method, like the amount of toner the printer prints and the surface quality of the copper clad board. But at least now I have one less variable that could mess up the end result. Project video was sponsored by PCB manufacturer and the project is related to homemade PCBs. Bold move. Let's see if it pays off.